Oh, what a fun treat we've got for you today. Mm-hmm. Chicagoans know him as the voice of the national anthem for the Chicago Cubs.
Oh, say can you see my...
For years, John Vincent has entertained us with his incredible voice. This year, he's kicking off the holiday season once again with a string of shows at Rizzo's Bar. The one-of-a-kind performance will include some holiday classics and popular covers of Frank Sinatra and Johnny Cash. The one and only John Vincent joins us now.
I love you guys. Thank you for having
me
here.
We love you right back. We love you right back.
No, I'm serious. You guys are too kind. I'm so happy to have the show and to be on here. Mm-hmm. And I've been learning a lot of new songs, different voices I was telling you about.
Yep. Tell us.
Sorry about my allergies. It's killing me.
That's okay.
The one song I just sang was, Tennessee Whiskey. And people like
it. You're doing a little country?
I am. Because I had the Johnny Cash always.
Yeah. So,
Coach Ditka was the one always like, Johnny, try this voice, try this voice.
Right.
Try this voice. So I was like, all right. And I'm glad I did, because if I would have just been doing Frank, mm-hmm. I don't think I would have had the shows that kept coming my way.
Yeah.
So Coach would always say, from Louis Armstrong to, what a wonderful world, to Johnny Cash. That was all Coach's idea.
That's got to be so tough, how you work on sort of the different voices and the different styles. Kind of what goes into it? How do you prepare for something like that?
I just keep playing the song and then sing along with it.
Like mimicking,
just like if you're in the car driving, mm-hmm. right? So you're in a car driving, you just sing along to it.
Isn't this how you kind of discovered this talent, like singing in the shower or something like that?
It was when I was playing football, I would drive the guys crazy in college. I would sing in the locker room.
Uh-huh.
And one of my friends who passed away at 48, Steve, he was a Marine. He came back from the Gulf War at that mm-hmm. time. And in the locker room, he'd start singing Sinatra songs.
Yeah.
And we'd mess the words up and have fun with it and call this goofy stuff. And he's kind of like, hey, you kind of sound like him. You should sing. And my sister always told me I should sing both sisters. And it just went from there.
Yeah.
And I got lucky. And then Coach Ditka and Mrs. Ditka just helped with everything.
Yeah.
I saw the Lady Gaga tweet up there. That was a big help. And Mr. Ricketts and the Cubs and Crank Kenny and Joe Madden. Everybody, the Rizzo, you name it. I've been
the
lucky.
The rest is history.
Look at you now, a Chicago icon.
No.
You are. Chicago's very own.
Tell us about the Rizzo's shows, mm-hmm. because they are just geared for the holidays.
Yes, it's going to be, I'll be doing all different songs, and I'll probably be doing some holiday music, and they're like maybe 5-6 songs mm-hmm. total. The first show, we're going to have Daniela Krako. She's a singer. She's amazing.
Uh-huh.
We just practiced the other day. She's going to sing with me on the first show. The second two shows will be just me. But I'll do my normal stuff that I used to do with the Sinatra stuff, but then all this other new stuff with holiday music, Christmas songs, everything else like that.
Yeah. Dina Bear was saying that it's a great way to get people into the holiday spirit and kind of kick off the holidays.
Yeah.
She watched the show last year as well. So.
It's fun. It's a lot of fun. And I'm excited. It's always a good time.
Yeah. And you've got so many cool things that you're working on. Not just the music. Obviously, that's a big part of some of the things that you do.
Sorry,
but you're so
don't.
I get emotional sitting next to Lourdes too. It's okay.
I bring it out in people.
I'm worried about breaking this chair. I got my allergies.
No, you do so many cool things, and one of the things that you really work on is really encouraging kids, inspiring kids. You go to schools and talk to them. Tell me a little bit about that.
I'll go to any school anywhere mm-hmm. to speak for free, because I was bullied when I was a kid, and then I grew 8 inches junior senior year. And when I grew 8 inches, and after that, I hated a person very, very much.
Mm-hmm.
And that person I hated the most was myself. I looked at myself in the mirror every day and I hated myself. That was my biggest enemy, was me. And I had to figure that out, that I don't need to love myself, I just need to be. And this life is so short and everything is so crazy. At some point, when do we say, hey, let's stop? And I think COVID and everything else that happened and all the other stuff that's been happening, mm-hmm. you just kind of look at it and you're like, no, let's make the best of this for everyone.
And that's been your attitude that we've all gotten to know. Artie, you can see John Vincent sing in person at one of three performances next month at Rizzo's Bar and Inn in Wrigleyville. The information right there on your screen. What a handsome picture.
Oh, yeah,
look
right.
at you. Qué guapo.
Sign up for tickets. No wonder he's getting emotional.
Wait, did you say what, a hippo?
No.
But you could have said that would have worked.
Artie, stay tuned. John's actually going to sing for us live in just a couple of minutes. Maybe a little Besame Mucho duo.
Besame Mucho.
Besame Mucho.
Yeah, the TVs just went off because they heard me sing.